Welcome to the Ayala Art I Love to Paint channel. This is your artsy friend, Martha. If you're art inclined, love art journaling, acrylic painting, and mixed media, this is your channel. Hey, I just want to paint backgrounds. Get your acrylic paint, your crayons, brushes, and art journal to paint with me. Welcome to the fourth Sunday of every month, Video Hope collaboration organized by Meridel. Thank you for being here. I hope you've been having fun with all the Hope videos that you watched previously. We have a hashtag, is hashtag Fourth Sun Hope. Check in the chat for the next link so you don't miss it. And if you're watching the replay, check in the information box below so you can binge on all the videos. There's a bunch of us participating. If you're new here, subscribe. And if you're enjoying this Hope, click like. That will be highly appreciated. Okay, first I want to show you a quick journal flip through, and then we're going to start painting the backgrounds. Hopefully we can make two. If time allows, we can make three. And if I just talk too much, we'll make at least one, right? This is done in all blues and greens, a little bit of purple. And it's just pretty much just to play with the brushes. Some of these have a video. I don't know if you're into kind of more realistic look. That is a little dog that was in the news. I painted it. And this is just like gesso page. Eventually I will paint something on it. Some are still like pencil lines, just brushing around. I have been working on this journal, which is supposed to be for dry media, but I love how the paper wobbles. So I put wet media as well. And I love leaving faces kind of half started for the 29 faces challenge, which is a lot of fun. And if you kind of leave them half started, when you feel like it, you come to a page and you just keep going a little bit or a lot. So you never have to deal with a blank page. This one has a lot of texture. It is a medium that had like little flakes. I wouldn't use it for everything because it's just too dense, but it's a lot of fun to play with different media, right? Different mediums. And drawings, and just a little bit of the same color with different values. This one, I'm sure you cannot see what it is. I don't know if the camera can catch it. It is just gesso. With the back of the brush, I made some drawings. Eventually I will paint it, but at that point, I just wanted to do that. And this is just literally just brushing to clean the paintbrush before I clean it completely. And then eventually, it, you know, you can develop a face. It doesn't have to be neither realistic, not pretty. It's just whatever it is. I actually like this one. I think it's pretty. But, you know, beauty is in the eye of the beholder, right? And this is another face. This, I was testing this other iridescent paint. I don't know if the camera can catch it, but it's very pretty. At least, you know, the paint. The face, I am okay with it, but it's, you know, not my favorite, but I enjoy painting it. And this, just flowers. Some drawings. I'm not sure if I ever will finish painting them because I like them how they are with the black and white. And it is acrylic paint in the charcoal pencil. So I just added a little bit of water and it gives some just light shading. I went along with another one, and in this one I went a little more into the face shadowing and making a little bit of depth. These, I made actually two of them. One was for a collaboration, and this one, I liked the collaboration so much, I came and did the same thing, but without the texture of the other canvas. This is in my journal, but the other one was in a canvas with heavy texture, and it looked really nice. And just some random framing for something later on. And more faces. Debbie Bowie, half done. I like doing this a lot. I just put put a wet napkin, just smash it in on a page and let it dry, and it gives you this beautiful background. I love it. I don't even know what to put in front of it because I like it so much as it is. See, this is another one. And this is another one that I made in a video. And more faces. Some are based on an image and some are just something that comes out of my imagination, just, you know, whatever. And this is another stamp that I made and I was just testing it. This background is very simple, but it looks really nice. Some, I don't know, year in the future, I will paint something. For now, I'm enjoying it just as it is. And I don't usually write on my pages. I don't even know why. Sometimes I put a word, sometimes I put something like this that has something written and you cannot even read it, but it's words. And it's fine if you want to just write a lot of stuff or don't write anything and just leave it visual, it's just as good. You can do whatever you want in your journal. If you're new to the journals, you know, that's a good comment to hear. But if you have been working on sketchbooks or our visual journals or journal books, you know already that you do whatever you want, right? The sky is the limit. Same for this one. This was something that I dragged around and then I went with the brush to kind of smear it even more. This one too, and later on I added a little bit of leaves and a little more of a framing. I wanted to put a face in here at some point. So that's the idea, but you know, it doesn't have to happen in a due date. And this is fabric. This is just regular collage paper. I believe these were napkins. This is just paint. This is a video of another collaboration. It was a lot of fun. And as well as this and this. I'm not showing you this one because it's for the future. Sometime in December, you'll have to wait. And this was loosely based on Modigliani. At least the idea, right? And I'm not going to paint on this one right now, but it's just, you know, the first layer. What I'm going to do is paint on a new blank page. So we're going to be working on this. I'm going to remove this in here. Let me see if I'm framed correctly. Okay. It's going to be kind of a weird angle, and sorry about that, but I don't have my camera setting the typical way, but it's still fun. If you have any questions at any point, or just, you know, saying hi, go in the chat, and sorry about that. We can talk in there. I'm going to make, at least that's my idea at this point, I want to make something in green with leaves. So I'm going to be using this brush, which I just realized is not completely cleaned, but it doesn't matter because I want texture, you know. So I'm going to make it just a little damp, and I'm going to pick up my green paint. And I'm going to just go all around. I usually, what I do is I put something under so I don't end up with glued pages. There. So I can reach all the way to the end without worry. Now, painting has been one of the things that has kept me sane, and most likely you too, during this crazy year. because it doesn't matter if you finish or not. At least to me, it doesn't really matter. You feel like, I don't know, like relaxed and recharged, distracted, hopeful, ignoring the world. I hope you're doing okay. I hope you're still keeping your marbles. And I hope that, you know, health and jobs and everything is going well your way, because it certainly has been stressing for 99% of the people. Okay, I have these. I'm going to wait for it to dry a little bit. Let me see. I'm just going to grab another piece of paper. I don't want to be making a lot of racket with the heat gun or the hair dryer, but this will dry kind of quickly. I put some water in it and it dries faster. Okay, now for the next thing, I'm going to be using this very simple leaves template. I think I want to use this one because it's kind of like more, I don't know, happier looking. Maybe I will use all of them, I don't know. Because I want it to be kind of like very subtle, almost not there. Of course I grabbed the corner that had a lot, but whatever. I say one thing and another thing happens. That's how it goes. Okay. And it is almost, well, it's a little bit more than what I wanted. Let me just get it a little. Yeah, that's more like it. Like you almost barely can see it. Just go over again before I lift it. And the same. Yeah, I can use a little bit more this way. There. So that's that. That's that, literally. Later on, I can write something, a quote, or maybe add a little bit of washi tape or something. I don't know at this point, but I know that I'm liking it that way. And the next, over here, I want to use this color, which is some kind of a rosy color. Or I cannot, oh yeah, here, dark Victorian rose. It's right here. So I want to have this color on this side, and then I want to add this with this other green. I think the two together are going to look amazing. Has nothing to do one page with the other. I don't even care. I just want to use something that I had in my mind for a while. I'm going to put a lot of water with this one. I'm going to go very slow in the edge. It's a little darker than what I imagined, but still good. I actually think it's a beautiful color. And I want it kind of patchy. Later on, my idea at least is to have like a type of a mermaid. That is why I want the fish in there. And I'm putting the paint with thick and light areas, so it looks very painterly. If you want to make a background super, super, super gently blended, I have a video I can put at the bottom in the information box below, because sometimes you want lots of texture and unevenness, and sometimes you want just some sweet, gentle blending. For this, I really literally want brushes to show. Sorry about all of this waiting, because, you know, I don't like you waiting, but this is what happens when you're painting. And I'm painting right now super fast. Usually I paint a lot slower. Now, there's two ways of doing what I have in my mind. One, I go around with a pencil and then go around with a small brush and paint all around the color that I like, which is, I think, what I'm going to be doing. And the other one is that you put it in here, either you load the stamp and use it as a stamp instead of a mask, you load it with paint, and then you just put it in here, like this would be. Another option is what I'm going to be doing. I'm going to draw it, I'm going to paint it, and then once it's dry, I'm going to put it again on top, and then I'm going to go with a lighter color, brushing it around. So let's start drawing this. Behind, my idea is that behind this, the fish and all, I will be painting a mermaid. This fish is kind of a little, just like barely making it. I'm going to use it anyway, but preferably I like the thing that I'm going to paint to have more room in the sides. But sometimes you just, you know, well, you just do what you can and then modify as needed. Did I go all over? Yes. Okay, we're going to put Mr. Fish over here, and I'm going to get the paint on my little palette that I have over here on the side with this green, which is bright yellow green. And I love Liquitex. I love the Liquitex paint a lot. Okay, we're just going to go not too slow. First, I'm going to go all around, and then later on, I will go into the rest of the shape. If you haven't been here before, this is the time to remind you that you can click on the subscribe button. If you like more videos on art journaling and acrylic paint, because that's pretty much what I do. And I can tell you right now, I cannot see the brush, I mean the paint. I cannot see the pencil line. I'm going to have to get up and check on the other side. But that'll be when I finish this side, because I can see this side. And I know I don't have a lot of time, so, oh my gosh, I painted the eye. Doesn't matter, that's okay. Well, now I cannot see the eye either. That's okay, that's okay. We can always put more paint on top, so don't even worry. I made a video on how to delete and how to erase paint and how to patch something that you don't quite like, because I keep doing it. I either paint something that in the spot I didn't want, or I think this is over here like this, or it's not the right color or something. And you know what? I don't care about the eye anymore. I don't care. I'm just going to paint it, and later on I'm going to repaint it. For now, let's just make life easy and do the whole thing like this. And wow, I'm running out of paint, so I'm going to put a little bit more in my little pile of paint over here. This brush was a little too small, so it's kind of stripy, but I'm liking it. I'm liking it like this stripy. It makes like a fleshy texture for the fish. And, well, I don't know where the side over here is. Let me see. I'm going to go a little bit more with the pencil, because okay, there. Now I can see, and see, I was already out of the line. But if you're wanting to do something very precise, then you just add more of this paint, more of the other, and keep layering. This one I'm going to leave very brushy. And the only problem right now is that I don't have time to dry it with the dryer and wait until it dries without making too much noise. So I will put the next step with this still wet. And I don't think anything bad will happen. It will kind of erase a little bit this texture that I'm putting right now. Let me blow a little bit. Tell me in the comments or in the chat if you're liking this, if you like the colors. This is looking a lot darker than what I expected, let me tell you that. I thought it was going to be a little bit more pale, so I'm glad I put some water. It is at least diluted. No, it's not too dark, but the way it contrasts is fun. So if I had more time, which we are about to finish, oh my gosh, I better rush. And let me tell you, check on the chat for the next link where you have to hop, or if you're watching the replay, go in and check on the information box below for the link of the next person. And right now, what I'm going to do is add my white, which, first thing didn't come out, now it's a ton, it doesn't matter, let's keep moving. Okay, it's a little greenish. I just want, actually, to use this sponge, and I just want to kind of, well, it's not going where I want it. I wanted something more subtle, but it doesn't matter at this point. I just want the idea, yeah? It's just the idea. This is what happens when you're painting like too fast. And although I love the acrylic painting because it dries very fast, I don't like painting in a hurry. I take a long time and I usually edit the videos. It's like 3 hours of a painting session in less than 10 minutes because ain't nobody got time for that. I don't know if you like to see just watching one project and seeing the paint dry. Sometimes you don't. So anyway, I'm going over here, kind of diffusing this a little bit. All right. This is more or less what I had in mind. Let me show you. I'm going to angle this again. So you can see better. Whoops. That's my timer. I have to say goodbye now. Thanks for visiting. I hope you had a lot of fun. I love that you're here. And check for the next video so you can hop over there. Remember to keep your paintbrush wet. And I am so happy you visited. All right, bye.